Hello viewers, let me discuss about chronic glomerulonephritis. Okay, this is the part 3 regarding renal disorders. Okay, in this we are going to discuss definition of chronic glomerulonephritis. Okay, in this definition is there. The definition: impairment of renal function. Okay, in this disease condition, what happens means impairment of renal function. What is the normal renal function? The renal system having normal function, purification of blood and formation of urine, excretion of urine. Okay, this is the normal function of renal, kidney. But who are affected by this disease condition of chronic glomerulonephritis? Those children are having a failure their normal function of renal system. Okay, why the normal function of renal system, why this failure means? Glomerular membrane is there, no? That glomerular membrane thickening. Okay, normally they are having the thin, but in this disease condition, completely thickening of glomerular. That's why the function of renal system will be failure. Okay, simple term, failure of renal function due to the thickening of glomerular thickness. Okay, this is the definition of chronic glomerulonephritis. Next we go for causes for the glomerulonephritis. Okay, in these causes, especially some glomerular diseases. Okay, in this glomerular disease, sometimes infection, sometimes tumor formation, sometimes blood clot or thrombus formation. Okay, any structural abnormalities is there in the glomerular, due to that the child may be affected by this chronic glomerulonephritis. Okay, this is one reason. Another one is the sometimes drug induced nephropathies. Okay, sometimes due to the chronic diseases, some heart diseases or some type of GI diseases. Okay, the child continuously using drugs. Okay, excessive drugs using, there is one side effect of this glomerulonephritis. Okay, another one is the systemic lupus erythematosus. Okay, it is a one type of blood disorder. Any systemic blood disorders is there. Due to that, the child may be affected by this disease of chronic glomerulonephritis. Okay, next we go for discuss regarding pathophysiology. Okay, in that pathophysiology, due to the repeated episode of acute glomerulonephritis. In previous videos, we have discussed about acute glomerulonephritis. No, okay. Acute glomerulonephritis. How the disease will come means mainly due to the streptococcal infection. Okay, repeated episodes, one or more times the streptococcal infection is there in the glomerulus. It may be leads to one complication, that is the chronic glomerulonephritis. No, okay. Due to that, the child many times affected acute glomerulonephritis. Okay, this repeat episodes, this may be leads to destruction of glomeruli. Okay, this normal structure of glomerular membrane, the structure will be completely destroyed. Okay, it leads to what happens means loss of renal function. Okay, the normal renal functioning should be completely lost. It leads to what happens means glomerular sclerosis. Okay, in this glomerular sclerosis, what it means, why the glomerular sclerosis means glomerular normal structure should be hardening. Okay, thickness. It leads to what happens means kidney reduced their normal structure. Okay, normal size. ओके राइट किडनी और लेफ्ट किडनी, विच किडनी इज अफेक्टेड बाय दिस इन्फेक्शन ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकल इन्फेक्शन. ओके इन दिस टाइम वॉट हैपन्स मीन्स दिस किडनी साइज विल बी रेड्यूस्ड. हाउ द प्रोसेस विल कम्स मीन्स इन दैट किडनी वन कॉर्टेक्स स्ट्रक्चर इज देयर नो. द कॉर्टेक्स शुड बी श्रिंकेज. ओके कॉर्टेक्स स्ट्रक्चर कंप्लीटली श्रिंकेज 1 to 2 millimeters, that leads to the normal structure should be completely reduced. Okay, what is the normal structure of normal size of kidney means in this 10 to 13 centimeters of size of normal kidney. It leads to what happens means scar formation makes to kidney rough. Okay, in that glomerular membrane. Complete scar formation is there. Okay, it leads to kidney should be irregular in size. In normally kidney will be which shape? Okay, the kidney will having the beam shape. No, in that kidney will having this irregular shape. Okay, it leads to thickening of renal artery. Okay, the renal artery should be thickened. It leads to the erythrocyte or end stage renal disease. Okay, ESRD, end stage renal disease. This is regarding pathophysiology of chronic glomerular nephritis. Okay, next we discuss about clinical manifestations for glomerular nephritis. Okay, in that chronic glomerular nephritis, what are the clinical manifestations? The child is having means in that first one is the asymptomatic. In early stages, there is no symptoms. Okay, there is no particular symptoms regarding this disease condition. Absence of symptoms. Okay, first in incubation period of streptococcal infection, in starting stage, there is no symptoms. Okay, we are not identified any symptoms. Okay, after that the child may have the edema. Okay, next another one is the hypertension, increased BP. The blood pressure should be increased than the normal blood pressure. Okay, next sometimes the child may have the hematuria, means urine from the blood. Okay, once the child will be excreted urine, in that urine sometimes blood will be mixed. Okay, why? Because failure, no, the growth glomerular filtration rate will be failure. Okay, GFR. Okay, glomerular filtration rate failure, the kidney normal function also altered, that's why the blood should be excreted with the urine. Okay, that's why the child may have the one symptom, that is the hematuria. Okay, next another symptom like nocturia. Means the child in daytime irregular excretion of urine, in that night time the child having the excessive urination. Okay, another symptom like anemia. Why the anemia? The blood not purified, the blood should be excreted through the urine, no, that's why the child may be loss of hemoglobin, that's why the child having the less hemoglobin percentage in their body. Okay, next another symptom like the child's having the bone pain. Okay, who are affected by this chronic glomerular nephritis, those children are having the bone pain. Another one is the FTT. In previous video we have discussed in detail about FTT, no, failure to thrive, means growth failure. Okay, the child having loss of success in their growth. Okay, according to their age, there is no normal growth, normal structure and functions of the body parts. Okay, this will be failure. Okay, these are the symptoms we are identified who child suffering with the chronic glomerular nephritis. Okay, next we are discussed about diagnosis. Okay, what is the major diagnostic procedures regarding this disease condition means in this first of all normal functioning, normal assessment, health assessment, history collection. Okay, in that history collection, we are collecting the history regarding children's baseline data we are collected. Okay, we decided the child will be suffering with the renal system disorders. Okay, after that we go for the second examination, that is the urine examination. Okay, by collecting urine sample from the children, okay, we have to label it and we have to examine for in that blood, in that urine, any blood cells or any pus formation or any albumin levels or any protein levels or any sodium potassium loss is there, that will be examined in detail. Okay, after that another examination, ECG, okay, electrocardiography. Okay, what is the normal structure, normal functioning of the heart? Why we have to do this examination means, in that heart their functioning may be failure, it leads to the chronic glomerular nephritis. Okay, that's why we have to assess the ECG. Okay, next another one is the blood examination. Why we have to blood examination means, RBC count, WBC count, is there any abnormalities in the WBC or RBC? Okay, what is the normal hemoglobin percentage? Regarding this, we have to examine in the children's. Next, another one is the chest X-ray. Okay, what is the structure and functions of the lungs? That will be identified by doing this type of chest X-ray. Sometimes we have to do the renal biopsy. Okay, in that why we have to do the renal biopsy means, which kidney, right kidney or left kidney? Okay, which kidney is affected by this chronic glomerular nephritis? Okay, what is the infection? What is the causative organism? Is there any cancerous cells or is there any streptococcal infection or is there any immune disorders? Okay, what is the exact cause for the kidney? That will be identified by take out the infected part from the kidney. That will be examined under the laboratory test and the microscopic examination. We have to find out this exact problem of the kidney. That's why we have to do the renal biopsy. Okay, next one is the USG, ultrasonography. Okay, what is the normal structure, functions of kidney? Is there any abnormality of kidney? That will be identified by doing this type of ultrasonography. Okay, especially in that nephron or in that glomerular membrane, okay, any structural or any functional abnormalities is there, that will be identified by doing this type of USG. Okay, next we are going to discuss about management. Okay, what is that management means? We have to provide symptomatic treatment. Which type of symptoms is there on the children? Okay, that symptom especially, what is that? Edema formation is there, means for reducing edema we have to administer some drugs. Okay, for control of hypertension we have to administer antihypertensive drugs. Okay, for example, the child having the growth failure, means for improving their growth we have to provide protein rich diet or carbohydrate rich diet or vitamin rich diet. Okay, what is their problem? Okay, symptomatic treatment, depending upon the symptoms we have to provide the treatment for the children. Okay, next another management, like antibiotics. Why? Because the infection only cause for this chronic glomerular nephritis, no? Okay, for control of infection, for reducing the severity of infection, we have to administer the antibiotics to the children. Okay, next another one is that we have to give steroid hormonal therapy. Okay, for control of these problems. Okay, next another one is the immune suppressive drugs. If the child having the any immunity disorders, okay, due to the alteration in the immunity system, the child may be affected by this type of glomerular nephritis, means the for control of this one we have to administer the immune suppressive drugs. Okay, this is the medical management for the chronic glomerular nephritis. Next we go for complications. Okay, in that complications, what is that means? First of all, acute nephrotic syndrome. Okay, if the in early stages chronic glomerular nephritis we are not treated means the child may be affected by this problem of acute nephritic syndrome. Another one is the hypertension, the blood pressure cannot controlled. Sometimes the child may be affected by this disease of hyperkalemia. Next, another one is the chronic kidney disease. Okay, long time the kidney not having normal functioning. Okay, these are the complications. Next one is the last step, that is the prognosis. In that prognosis, what happens means the chronic kidney failure. Okay, kidney cannot having any function. Okay, lifelong there is no functioning of kidney. Next, another one is the reduced kidney function. Some childrens may have the functioning will be there, but normal function not there. Slowly the functioning of the kidney. Okay, next last one is the end stage kidney disease may affected by these childrens. Okay, this is the prognosis. Next, our role, nurses' role. What is our role? Means, as a nurse, we have to provide complete care to the children. What is the symptomatic treatment? What type of drugs prescribed by the physician? That drugs we have to administer by following the five rights. Okay, right drug, right route, right medicine, right time is there. No, they following this five rights, we have to administer the medications to the children. And as a nurse, we have to improve the bed rest, and we have to provide complete health education to the children, and we have to improve the personal hygiene of the children. Why? Because this is the one problem. It will be mainly affected by the poor personal hygiene. Okay, who are not having any bathing, good bathing, or they are not taking a good grooming, or any they are not maintaining personal hygiene means. Okay, the disease may be affected to the children. Okay, as a nurse, we have to improve the personal hygiene of the children. Okay, next we have to provide psychological support to the mother. Why? Because in early stages, in childhood stage, the child having the kidney failure or glomerular filtration rate decreased, or blood purification not there, or urine not excreted by the children means the mother having so much of tension, anxiety, fear regarding children's health. Why? Because in childhood stage, the child not tolerate this type of diseases. Okay, the child not cooperative for taking medicines. Okay, the mother having more risk. Okay, more health problems. That's why we have to improve the, or we have to give psychological support to the mother. Why? Because so many of medications will be available in our society for control of this type of diseases. Okay, next another one is the first of all we have to provide proper food to the children. Why? Because they are having a balanced diet they are taking means they are having a good immunity power. Proper immunity is there in the body means the child not affected by any diseases. Okay, that's why we have to give proper food to the children. Okay, final conclusion in regarding this disease condition. First of all, in early stages, okay, once the child will having the one problem, that is the decreased urine output, means immediately we have to consult the doctors. Why? Because in early stages we have to treat means there is no complications. Okay, if early stages acute chronic glomerular acute glomerular nephritis we are treated means the child does not affected chronic glomerular nephritis. Okay, in early stages we are neglected that particular disease condition means that may be affected to, or that may be leads to chronic glomerular nephritis. After that it leads to the end stage renal disorders. Okay, that's why in early stages the child having any symptoms, any problem means, okay, immediately we have to consult the doctor. Okay, this is the main advice to the mothers regarding your children's health. Okay, why? Because we have to protect the children's health. Okay, the child not telling proper problem, no. Okay, they are not having a good awareness regarding their health, no. okay, we only protecting their health, no? That's why we have to take care of children's health. Okay, thank you everyone. Thank you for watching this video.